how have you found World of Learning? Has it been useful for you?
It has. You know, one of the things that we've really appreciated is the quality of the conversations. So we've had a lot of good conversations with people who are really targeted and looking for things that are going to help them be more successful in their training. You know, in some cases, that's looking at ways they can do more with less, or just ways they can expand their ability to reach out and scale what they're already doing from classroom to more of e-learning.
We've had some good conversations
talks
with people.
Yeah.
Yes, a bunch of fun, including you. We've met some interesting people.
Yeah.
So we're looking so that we can get some associates to do more associate work with ways of collaborating. And what's interesting is that there seems to be quite a strong focus on e-learning, and yet there's quite a strong, for the people that here are doing more experiential creative learning, which is a smaller group, it's interesting for us to actually meet with those and see what they're doing on the creative front.
Do you think experiential and therapeutic learning could ever work together with e-learning, or do you think it's a totally different...
I don't personally think so.
E-learning it tends to be a little bit drier because you're just interacting with the screen. But where creative parts can come in is actually with the designers of the learning courses. So say, for instance, we've had discussions with people who want to look at a creative way of making something like health and safety or risk management safety business, which are quite dry subjects, to make it more lively and just make the interaction more colourful, more engaging than just being tick boxes and multiple choices. So that's the way it would come together, I think. That's the way it needs to work.
Briefly, what do you think of the World of Learning yourself?
Yeah, really good. It seems there's a lot going on. It seems a lot of buzz about it. There's all sorts of things, laughter workshops. Following on Twitter before I got here, there is a lot of talk about social media, so that's clearly something that's on the mind of people. So, it seems good.
Again, I think it's a very good exhibition. Of course, it allows us to make people discover about our bespoke learning solutions and serious games. And of course, to get some interesting contacts. People are really interested in our product, so we are quite happy.
What do you think the issues for trainers in the next 12 months are going to be? What do you think the problems or, you know, hurdles they're going to have to get over are going to be?
I think, of course, the big one that's probably on everybody's mind is the economy and how do we keep being effective? How do we prove that we're actually adding value to our organization? I think that's always a concern, something that I don't know that a lot of training professionals really have been trained well or have figured out that process. I think also using these more collaborative tools. So I was following the Twitter stream today and just hearing some of the comments were this refresh. I want to be refreshed. I want to go back into the classroom. I don't want to do everything with e-learning. So I think finding that proper balance between how much e-learning can we do, like all asynchronous, and how much synchronous stuff can we do, and how do we still keep that human connection without, you know, because there's something about being face-to-face and having a conversation with someone that really can make a big impact. Not that e-learning can't do that, but we got to find that proper balance across kind of the spectrum. So I think that's going to be a big challenge over the next 12 months. How do I do social? How do I use all these e-learning tools? And how do I keep the human connection? Great.